Hi, this is JP from Northern Lights over Arkham. This time I'm playing the brand new hero Ant-Man, and I'm playing against Absorbing Man on standard difficulty. The only thing that is not as suggested is that I added the Bomb Scare modular set into the encounter deck, just to vary it up a bit. So I won't go into detail of the Ant-Man deck. It's the pre-built leadership deck that comes with the hero pack. So this will be my first play of this pack, so let's get started. I have pre-shuffled the decks, and already I resolved the setup that we have the snowy hillside environment in play. So it has the ice keyword and forced response: after Absorbing Man makes an undefended attack against you, place one threat on the main scheme, two threat instead if there are five or more delay counters on the main scheme. So let's draw our opening hand. As I said, I'm playing the pre-built deck. I haven't looked at the cards that much. I'll go through the new cards in detail when I play them. So we get... I need one more card. So we get the Giant Man. I think it's a bit too expensive right at the start. Reinforced suit, not that useful. Pim particles. Giant strength, an upgrade. I think that's a keeper. We want that in play. Resize. Okay. Moxie. I think we'll mulligan these. Well, let's keep the pin particles. No. Let's moxie. Shuffle these. Mulligan these, and we get swarm tactics, strength, first aid, and team building exercise. So this is not a good starting hand by any means. So let's see what we'll start doing. As there is only two threats, I think I will... I'll use the swarm tactics to play the giant strength. So giant strength is a one cost upgrade. It's a condition. Giant response: after you change to giant hero form, you get plus one attack until the end of this round. So I'm thinking we are going to change into giant. Let's see. Then we have team building exercise. It's a support. I think we'll play this. So hero action: exhaust team building exercise. Play a card from your hand that shares a trait with your hero, reducing its resource cost by one. So that's a good build up. So we'll use strength to lay that down. And these two are a bit useless at the moment. Okay, so let's see. Do we want to change into Ant-Man? So I think we'll change into Ant-Man, the tiny version. That allows us to... So I'll use this to indicate if I'm used the once per turn card flip to change from alter ego to hero form or to another form. So we'll trigger the puny pest. So response: after you change to this form, remove one threat from a scheme. So I'll remove one threat from here, and then I will use resize. So hero action: change to your other hero form, draw one card. And I'll change to Ant-Man giant version. And now After you change to giant hero form, you get plus one attack until the end of the round. So we have an attack of four. And we draw a card from the resize. And we get power gloves. So it's it attaches to an Avenger ally, so not that useful. So I think we are just discarding this. But I'll attack for four. So we deal 4 damage to Absorbing Man. And that is our turn. We ready up. I'll discard this because we don't have allies that we need those cards for. And we have a hand size of 4 in giant form. So we get 4 cards. We get another team building exercise, Giant Storm. Army of Ants and Ronin. So we'll go into detail on those cards if we play them. We start the villain phase. We add a threat here. Absorbing Man attacks. Let's see. I think I'm giant stomping, so I just defend for this attack. So I'm defending for 3. Absorbing Man hits for 2 plus. So boost reveal this card, so this comes into play. So Absorbing Man gets the ball and chain, so attach to Absorbing Man, hero action, spend strength resource, shuffle this card into the encounter deck, and it gives plus one scheme and plus one attack. And it it doesn't search, so it just gives plus one. So Absorbing Man hits for 3. We are defending, so this doesn't trigger. So we don't take any damage. And that is the attack. And we see the encounter card. And it is a Hydra regular. It has inside 1. So we add 1 threat here. Oh yeah, and I forgot the forced response. After resolving step 1 of the villain phase, place 1 delay counter here. So we'll place that now. And this guy comes into play. And that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. Okay, let's see what we can do this turn. So I think we could just giant stomp. Or play Ronin. I think playing Ronin is better. We are not in that of a rush to defeat Absorbing Man, so well, I could giant stomp and almost get to the phase 2, but I think we'll take it a bit slow, so I'll play Ronin. Ronin is an Avenger, so I am an Avenger. I'll use the team building exercise. So I exhaust team building exercise. Actually, let's see. I'll use Army of Ants and Team Giant Storm to. No, I don't have enough. Okay. Let's just play Ronin. And I'll pay for him using Giant Storm and team building exercise. And Ronin gets plus one ward and plus one attack while an upgrade is attached. And so no upgrade is on him. So we'll just attack to defeat the Hydra regular. Then I think I will flip to tiny form. And I'll remove. Oh yeah, I forgot to deal the 1 damage to an enemy last turn from flipping to the giant form, so I'll do it now. A bit late, but still. And now that I flip, I'll remove 1 threat. Then I think I'll keep the army of ants in hand because I want to get it into play. So that, yeah, we are exhausted still. So I think that is our turn. We ready up. We draw back up to 5. So the tiny version has a hand size of 5. We get the call for aid, stinger, call for aid, in particles and army of ants. We'll add a threat to the main scheme and one delay counter here. Absorbing man attacks. I think I'll defend with Ant-Man. So 3 plus 2. So we'll take 3 damage. Encounter card is false alarm. You are confused. I'll add a confused token to Ant-Man. And that is the villain phase, so let's go to the next hero phase. So I think the first thing, we are tiny. I'll use the team building exercise to play Army of Ants, which has the ants and tiny keywords. So hero action, if you are in tiny hero form, exhaust Army of Ants, deal 1 damage to an enemy. So I'll just do that now. I'll deal 1 damage. Then actually, let's back up. I use the pim particles to play Army of Ants. This way, I'll get to draw a card because I'm in a tiny form. I get Moxie. I have the Avenger trait, so I'll use that to play Stinger. And Stinger will eat for 1 damage. Then I will call for aid. So you discard cards from the top of your deck until you discard an Avenger ally. Let's we get Wasp. And somehow I miscalculated how much resources I have because I used this team building exercise. Okay, maybe that should have been done as a first thing. Oh well, I think we'll play Wasp next round. And I'll just make a bit more room because there are a lot of allies to play, and a Stinger doesn't count towards the maximum amount of allies you can have. Ronin will, well, there's nothing to attach to Ronin, so I think I'll flip to giant form. Ronin, oh yeah, and I'll deal 1 damage here. Then Ronin will hit for 2 damage. And I will spend 1 resource, strength resource, physical resource to remove this. So this gets shuffled into the encounter deck. And I think that is my turn. I will use Moxie. So Moxie is a new event. It's a zero cost event. Hero response. After you change your change form, you get your hero gets +1/4, +1 attack, and +1 defense until the end of the round. So I'll boost the defense to 4, and then I ready up. And I'll draw back up to 4. So I get wrist gauntlets, Ant-Man, the Hank Pym version, and power gloves, and I have the Wasp. So I can have Ant-Man, Hank Pym, and Ant-Man in play because this is the Scott Lang, I forgot the name, Scott Lang version of Ant-Man. So I can have both of them in play at the same time. And let's go to the villain phase. We add a threat here. We add a delay counter here. Absorbing man attacks. I think I still defend with Ant-Man. So, well, no, let's defend with Stinger. So, let's see, Absorbing Man hits for 3 damage, so Stinger is defeated. Encounter card is gang up. Absorbing Man attacks again. Let's defend with... I'll just defend with Ant-Man. I think we want to hit Ronin. So, 2 plus 2 is 4, and we have a defense of 4, so we don't take any damage. And that is that, so that is the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. So, I think we are just playing... Well, I think I'm not playing Wasp this turn. I'll change back into tiny version. So we'll remove one threat from a scheme. I'll deal one damage with the army of ants. I'll play Ant-Man, a Hank Pym version. And so, let's see, this doesn't work, so I'll have to overpay. I'll overpay with Wasp and overpay with Power Gloves. So we place 2 Pym counters on Ant-Man. So this gives the 2 hit points to Ant-Man and Pym. Then we don't have the resources to play the wrist gauntlets. Let's back up. I'm not playing the Ant-Man this turn. I'll play the wrist gauntlets. I'll play them with Ant-Man, Hank Pym. And I'm still exhausted. Then I'll play Power Gloves on Ronin. So Ronin has attack of 3, and then it reads after attached ally attacks or thwarts, deal 1 damage to an enemy. So we attack, we deal 3 damage. So Absorbing Man goes to phase 2. So when revealed, if super absorbing power is in play, deal 1 encounter card to each player, otherwise search the encounter deck and discard pile for super absorbing power and reveal it, shuffle the encounter deck if it was to search this way. Okay, so Absorbing Man gains the ice, metal, stone, and wood traits. And Absorbing Man has 15 health. And now we just need to defeat Absorbing Man before time runs out. And then I'll deal one with the Power of Gloves. Then Ronin takes the third consequential damage. And we ready up. We get 5 cards. We get Moxie. Reinforced Suit times 2. Power Gloves and Resize. Okay. Let's go to the villain phase. We add a threat here. We add an delay counter here. Absorbing Man attacks. I won't defend this turn. So we take 4 damage. And one threat gets added to the main scheme. And counter card is Omnimorph Duplication. When revealed, if Absorbing Man has the Ice trait, exhaust your identity. Well, that sucks. Metal, give Absorbing Man a tough status. That sucks too. Stone, give Absorbing Man one face down boost card. And Wood, discard one card at random from your hand. So we discard one Reinforced Suit. Okay, well, that was not pleasant. That is the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. Okay, let's see what we can do. There is not a lot we can do with this hand. So what I'm thinking of doing is just I'll play the Army of Ants to remove the tough, or exhaust it rather. I don't have anything to play. I will resize. And actually, do I have anything to? I could stun an enemy. I don't have 2 physicals or 2 mental, 2 energy resources, so that sucks. Well, this is very annoying. There's nothing that draws me cards, which would be really nice. So I think what we'll do is to I'll go to Alter Ego. So after you change to this form, heal 1 damage from Scott Lang. Then I will. Oh yeah, I think I may have misplayed at the start of the game. Well, I could have changed to hero form, then resize and change to other. Yeah, so that works that way. But the other way around, it doesn't work. So we'll back up a bit. I first changed to Ant-Man, giant version with 3 size to deal 1 damage, and I'm still exhausted. Then I will use the hero resize to go to Scott Lang. I'll heal 1. And that's it. I can't do anything with this hand, unfortunately. I'll discard the whole hand and draw back up to 6. We are exhausted, so we're ready up. We have a giant stomp, hive mind, call for aid, army of ants, Ant-Man's helmet, and team building exercise. We add one threat to the main scheme, and we add one delay counter. Absorb women schemes for 2+1. So we are at 9 threat. Oh yeah, and we get this extra boost card, which doesn't do anything, luckily. So this was a part of the scheming. And the encounter card for this turn is Alter Ego plays 2 threat on the main scheme, 3 threat for the absorbing man has the metal trait. Okay, so it has, we are at, I think we just lost the game. So we are at 9, we go to 12, and that is that. Okay, well, I think I will try this again. I played poorly. I should have played more allies. This wrist gauntlets were a bad play. Instead, I should have played something else. So I'll re-ease it up and we'll try this again. So I'll be right back. So this is the second attempt for Ant-Man against Absorbing Man on standard difficulty. Let's see how this game goes now. I'll just forgot to shuffle the decks. I'll do that quickly. So we'll search for an environment by discarding cards. So okay, we get the snowy hillside again. Then we'll shuffle and draw our opening hand of 6 cards. This time we get Power Gauntlet, Moxie, Sweet, Ronin, Energy, and Army of Ants. So I think this time we will play Ronin and boost him up quite a bit. We'll start by playing Ronin. I will play Ronin with Energy and the Power Gauntlets. So we'll play, we'll give the reinforced suit to Ronin with Moxie. So Ronin has +2 health, and we'll keep the army of ants in hand. We'll think we'll flip to tiny version. And we remove one threat from here. Then I think I'll just ward for 2. Yeah. And Ronin will hit for 3 damage. That is our turn. We're ready up. I keep the army of ants in hand. I'll draw back up to 5. We get call for aid, team building, giant storm, and call for aid. Okay. We go to the villain phase, we add a threat here, we add a delay counter here. Absorbing man attacks, Ant-Man takes the damage, I won't defend. We'll take 3 damage. And we add one threat here. Encounter card is stall tactics. When revealed, place one threat on the main scheme for every two delay counters on the main scheme. If no threat was placed in this way, this card gains search. So this card gains search. And placed hero take 3 indirect damage. 4 indirect damage instead if absorbing man has the metal trait. So we'll take the 3 indirect. Yeah, and I'll take all on Ant-Man. And that is the villain phase, so let's go to the next hero phase. Okay, and then we'll start our hero phase. I think I'm trying to Giant Storm this turn. Actually, no, I'll save the Giant Storm for next turn. This turn I'll play team building exercise with 2 call for aids. I'll use the team building exercise to play a tiny card, and I'll play the army of ants. I'll use the army of ants to deal 1 damage. I will flip to Ant-Man giant version. I'll deal 1 damage. Then Ronin hits for 3 damage. And Ant-Man hits for 3 damage. And that is it. I'll keep the Giant Stomp in hand. I'll draw back up to 4. After I ready up my cards. Okay, so we get 3 size, strength, giant strength, and giant stomp. So we are just gonna giant stomp the hell out of absorbing man. We go to the villain phase, we add a threat to the main scheme, we add a delay counter. So absorbing man attacks, I won't defend. I'll take 2 plus. So boost, put this card into play. So we change the environment metal. So we get 2 damage. And force response after absorbing man makes an undependent attack against you. Discard 1 source icon from your hand. Okay. I'll discard the giant strength. No, let's discard resize. Okay. And that we'll get the encounter card, and it is Shadow of the Past, so we get yellow jacket. Let's look at yellow jacket. So he's a 2 scheme and 2 attack criminal with 4 health. While you are in giant hero form, yellow jacket gains the giant trait and retaliate 1. While you are in tiny hero form, yellow jacket gains the tiny trait and gets plus 1 attack. Ant-Man's nemesis minion. Okay. Then we get tech theft. So treat the printed text box of each tech player card as if it were blank. Well, luckily we don't have any tech in play. And then we shuffle these cards into the encounter deck. And that is the... Oh yeah, let's put some threat here. So that is the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. I think Ronin is hitting Absorbing Man. So we go to phase 2. We'll search for the super absorbing power. Again, it's a right at the bottom of the deck. So that comes into play. I think we are just trying to burst down Absorbing Man. And Absorbing Man has 15 health. Then I will use Ant-Man to hit Yellow Jacket for 3 damage. Then I'll take one from the Retaliate because Yellow Jacket has gains Giant Trait and Retaliate when I'm in Giant form. I will use the Giant Strength and Strength to play Giant Stomp. So Giant Stomp is a 3 cost event. Play only if you are in... Actually, I'll use the team building and keep the Giant Strength in hand. Okay, so play only if you are in Giant Hero form. Hero action attack, deal 1 damage to each minion. So I deal 1 damage to here, and because that defeats Yellow Jacket, we don't take the Retaliate. Then deal 8 damage to an enemy, so I deal 8 damage to Absorbing Man. After that, I will go to Tiny Form and deal 1 damage with the Army of Ant, and also I will remove 1 threat from here. I'll keep this in hand. I'll draw back up to 5. We get Reinforced Suit, Wrist Gauntlets, Resize and Power Gloves. We'll ready up. We start the villain phase, we add a threat to the main scheme, Absorbing Man attacks. I think I'll this time defend with Ant-Man. Yeah. Okay, so 2 plus 2, so 4, we take 2 damage. Okay, we are nearly dead, but let's see if we can pull through. And counter card is, we place 1 threat on the main scheme, so that is that. So that is the villain phase, let's go to the next hero phase. Okay, let's see if we can get 6 damage in and defeat Absorbing Man. I think I'll just play the Power Gauntlets. I'll use Army of Ants to deal 1 damage. I will resize, so I deal 1 damage, and I think that is enough. So Ronin has +1 ward and +1 attack while upgrade is attached, so we'll hit for 3. And Power Gloves. After attached ally attacks or wards, deal 1 damage to an enemy. So we deal 1 damage and we defeat Absorbing Man. Okay, well, that game went quite differently. I may have missed maybe one delay counter, but still a decent beat up of absorbing man. Depending on the scenario, you might want to build up more, like get more allies like Wasp or Giant Man or the other Ant-Man into play, and boost them up with the reinforced suits and maybe some power gauntlets to just keep hitting with them. And I think the first aids are here to keep them healthy. Then you can just keep flipping from alter ego to the giant or tiny version. So I really like how the Ant-Man deck plays. I'm surely going to try out some different aspects with it. Hope you guys liked this first play, and as always, thanks for watching, and until next time.